be in church on this wonderful Tuesday afternoon. Looking forward to a powerful rest of the service on today. Looking forward to a powerful time in God on Wednesday as well as Thursday. Continue to pray up and talk it down, that the Lord will continue to meet us in this place in such a rich way, that the Lord will continue to have His way in us and through us through His singing as we praise and worship Him. Thank God, Sister Rick, and open us up to you, Garden Johnson. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. We have a singer in the house on this day. Dr. Roland Joe Smith is no stranger to the Greater Harvest Church. He is no stranger to the city of Baltimore and to the music ministry across our nation. We are blessed.
Amen.
Let me say this, we are blessed in Baltimore to have some of the
sent an invitation. He said, you're going to preach it. Dr. Roland Jim Smith will do for your guest songs. And it just did my heart glad. So when I saw him, I just gave him a quick. He could only a little. And he said, yeah, he can do that. But a great heart is even a pleasure to stand before you this afternoon. And to the great pastor of this church.
Well,
wanted his independence. He wanted his own life. He was tired of being in his father's household and tied to his family, his father's property.
Yeah.
The prodigal son rejected and turned away from the father's way of life because his father was too demanding and required too much.
Uh-huh.
He would restrict his fun and his pleasure or would not understand all that he was going through.
Yeah.
Some of those things sound familiar to some of us.
Yeah.
The father gave his son freedom and possession to do what he pleased.
Uh-huh.
He could live his life without his father's interference.
Yeah, yeah.
There are times when God will let us have what we want,
yes, sir.
Even though he knows we are able to have it.
Right.
But he gives it to us anyhow.
Yeah.
But it ain't nothing but a setup, church.
Set up.
Because how many times have God allowed us to go through situations that we weren't prepared to have? But by his grace and his mercy,
yeah,
we came through it, church.
Yeah.
We said it was nothing but the Lord.
Yeah.
I'm glad I have any company here this afternoon.
Come on now.
If it had not been for the Lord on our side, some of us even wouldn't even be here today. The Bible says we have pressed hard on every side, but yet not crushed. Perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed. The pigment was nothing but a setup.
Yeah.
So God could glory out what he wanted to cross the sun. They knew there was a calling. The father might know there was a calling on the young man's life.
Yeah.
There was something different about him than his older brother.
Yeah.
But he couldn't do what everyone else did, go through all the process.
Yeah.
Sometimes you gotta let your children just do what they have to do.
Wow.
And they'll come back to you later and tell you, Daddy, I'm sorry. Or Mama, I'm sorry. That's why we have to reflect a lot of times.
Uh-huh.
We have to reflect back on our lives and come and even tell the next generation that some nations no one even told us. I don't remember hearing when I was growing up about people being anointed for people fivefold ministry about church. They said just come to church.
That's right.
Go to church.
That's right.
They didn't tell me about anything about being saved, anything like turning my life around. But you know, when God has a hand in his hand on you, I don't care what you're going through, he will always bring you out of it. We're having company here this afternoon. He had a thinking experience. He's been a very low place in his life. And he had to reach out and call on the name of the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
That moment in a lot of times when the Lord has to take us down.
That's right.
In order to bring us back up high. I know a lot of times we downplay what our young people go through at times. Some of them leave home early to live alternative lifestyles. Some leave home because of abuse. Some of them leave home because their parents don't want them around anymore. That's why when you have young people in your church, you have to embrace them and encourage them at every opportunity. The prodigal son was at the point where his brother's possessions meant more to him than his family's household.
Well,
although he squandered it all that he had, wasted, misused his money, his property, his house, and his purpose. Church, a lot of us aren't where we are today from the sword we had years ago.
That's right.
We're the byproduct of what we went through years ago. But we have to be transparent enough, church, to let our young people know that I went through misuse of money. I had to file for bankruptcy. I was a deep credit card debt. Before caller ID, I was afraid to answer the phone. Because God was present for calling my house. And I didn't know who I was going to talk to. So I didn't even answer the phone because of God the presence that was going on in my house. So what did I tell my son then? That look, you can't get your money now. Because you don't want to have to go through what I go through. So first of all, you got to give to God first. Before anything else, give to God. And once you give to God, God will turn everything else around in your life. In the text, it said he persuaded the local farmer to hire him. And the man sent him in the fields to feed the pigs.
Yes,
get sloppy.
And they had corn. And if he was tempted to eat sloppy corn, you know he was in bad shape.
Yeah.
But God.
But God.
Tell your neighbor, but God.
But God.
God gave him a moment of clarity.
Yeah.
And made him realize that even his father's high service was living better than he was. The text says he came to himself. Some of us have been in situations where we came to our senses before it was too late. Some of us came to our senses after it was too late.
That's right.
You were already married that crazy joke. Next thing you know, she was pregnant. And crazy. Then you started praying for her, but she died. You should have stayed at your own job. You couldn't handle that car, though, the car that you really wanted. But the prodigal son had sense enough to go back home to his father. He reflected on his life and realized it was a wasted life. But then when he went back, he had to repent.
That's right.
He apologized to his earthly father and to his heavenly father. We don't hear the word repent too much anymore. When we repent, we turn around from our sinful ways and feel regret and feel sorry about what we've done. In other words, Lord, I'm sorry for how I've sinned against you. Repentance is a lifestyle, church. A change of life from the inside out. That we hear people say all the time, the Lord knows my heart. That's before I knew it, man, because they said the Lord knows my heart before they would do wrong and they would do it anyhow. But now I've come to my son, I've grown older now. They said the Lord knows my heart before you do this dirt. Yeah, he knows that you're going to do it even before you do it. The Bible says if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us from our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Before he had gotten home, the favor of God was on his life. The text says while he was still a long way off, his father saw him come. The father felt something in his spirit about his son. I used to think that only mothers had an intuition about their children. But fathers had it too. The difference is, mothers would pick up the phone and call and say, what are you going through? How are you doing? While fathers, we would sit there and let the stew inside of us. It says father was filled with love and compassion. He ran to his son and praised his son and kissed him. The text didn't say that he waited for an apology, or the father said, I told you so. But before the son could get anything out, the father embraced him. A lot of times our pride gets in the way of God's plan. He wants us to love one another as he has loved us unconditionally. The father felt compassion for his son. And we knew that everybody has something to say about him embracing his son. You know how we talk sometimes in church. I wouldn't give him anything else after he messed it up. After he done that right, he's gone looking for something else. But I heard one of the mothers of my church say, people always want to prophesy over your household when that household is in a mess. Hey, I can say. The text doesn't say a thing about a mother. Maybe the mother had just died. And because of the grief he had to leave home, he could have had a traumatic experience. But the text doesn't say. The text doesn't say that when he left because things got too bad for him to live at home. A lot of times we tease our son and tell him, when you're gone, you're gone. Because we got plans for your room, so when you're gone, you're gone. It ain't no coming back. We'll help you over there somewhere else. That doesn't mean that we don't love you. That don't mean that we can't come over sometime. But the father in the text, he just never stopped loving his son. He never stopped praying for him. Even though his son messed up, he found his way back home. His lost son had come home. And it was a time for celebration. The father told his servants to bring the finest robe. Put a ring on his finger. And put sadness on his feet. So after he reflected, after he repented, he had to reconcile his relationship with his father. Not only Got a whole lot of families grown up today because people don't want to